Special thank you to my YouTube members and patrons for supporting the channel and supporting my content. How's it going, everybody, and welcome back to another subreddit video. Today we are going to be returning to r/tfue or r/todayif**ed up. Pretty much as it sounds, it's people telling stories about how they had a little screw up, a little mess up. Quickly before we begin, I just wanted to mention that as always, I will be live on my Twitch on Thursday at 7 PM UK time, so go check that out, it's always a good time. Or equally, you can catch the stream on my YouTube channel the day after. That's Blue the Nerd Live on YouTube, so it'll be uploaded there the day after. Right, let's get into the subreddit, shall we? Tfue by getting caught by my wife about my lawn mowing scheme. Let me preface this by saying that I really, really enjoy mowing my lawn. My wife and I bought our house 5 years ago, and ever since, mowing the lawn has just brought out this peace inside me. So much so that I sold our riding lawnmower and bought a push mower. There is something so calm and relaxing about mowing at about 6:30 PM on a summer day. The sound of the mower, the smell of cut grass, and overall, the world around me. Much of it reminds me of my kid days riding our bikes around in the neighborhood on summer evenings. Sometimes I listen to podcasts or music, but mostly it's just taking in the sounds of the outside. I like it so much that I will literally mow every 3 days. Even if the grass barely needs a cm taken off the top, I will mow. My wife, however, thinks this is ridiculous. She thinks more than once every 7 to 10 days is absurd. She may be right, but it's not like I'm asking for much, as it takes a whole 90 minutes to push mow the entire yard. I'm essentially taking 3 to 3.5 hours a week of zen time. I noticed over time, as we would come home during the day, her way of gauging whether the lawn needed to be mowed was the length in the ditch at the mailbox. This is an area I tend to actually skip mowing and tend to keep this area on a 1 to 1.5 week trim cycle because it's kind of a pain in the ass spot, and we are on a country road, so it isn't exactly a curb appeal factor. After noticing this, I started raising the deck height on the mower to keep the grass higher in that spot, and sure enough, she would keep saying how the grass would need to be mowed, which means I was good to go as usual on my 3-day mow cycle. This went well for 2 years, until last night at dinner with friends. Drinks were flowing, laughs were being had, and our friend brought up mowing. The girls had this convo about men and their toys, yada yada, and during the laughs, I blurted out to the male friend, "Just do what I do and purposely make an area seem longer than it is," which was met with raucous laughter from all of us, except my wife. After about 10 seconds of laughter, I felt this intense heat on the right side of my face. It's a very familiar heat, very distinct. Once I calmed down from laughing, it set in instantly what I had just said. The heat I was feeling was the indescribable fury of her staring a hole through me. It was a very quiet night, and so far, a quiet morning. Too long didn't read, Tfue by making a small scheme to find reasons to mow the grass. Had a few too many fruity drinks at Texas Roadhouse, which caused me to blurt out my mowing scheme to our friends. Wife gave me the million mile death stare, has barely spoken to me. Edit, we have essentially no other tasks. We are very routine with things. I cook every night, then load the dishwasher. The vacuuming takes care of itself. We spot mop. I go to trash disposal on Saturdays since we are rural with no trash pickup. We go to the grocery store every Saturday, and she does laundry on Saturdays. We work in the same office on the same schedule, Monday to Friday, 9 to 5, and obviously ride together every day. There's a few things in this one that's like, I don't understand why she would have a problem with you mowing the lawn more than it needs to be mowed. Like, why is that an issue? Like, you're taking care of the garden, maybe too well, but you're taking care of it. Like, it's a weird one that, like, you would need to lie or feel the need to lie about it. Like, this should have just been a 5-minute conversation of you sit down, talk about the fact that, you know, it's some zen time and you really enjoy it, and that should have been the end of it. The need to lie is weird, but also, alternatively, you know, you could go through that discussion and agree that, you know, maybe the lawn only needs to be mowed once a week, but you could mow a neighbor's lawn, mow someone who is unable to mow their lawn because of mobility issues or such, or even offer to mow people's lawn for money, you know, get a little bit of money in there in the evenings doing something that you enjoy. Plenty of people don't want to mow their lawns, and if you enjoy it and you could make a little bit of extra money on it, why not? But I feel like this should have been a conversation. I'm sure she's not actually, like, angry at the fact that you were lying about, you know, mowing the lawn. Probably more annoyed at being the butt of the joke when it came to that. But it's still just a little bit weird to me that that mowing the lawn is something that needed to be lied about. Tfue by putting insane shit as my Venmo memo and having it read out loud in open court. Posting from my alt because I'm a whole ass business professional and I'm mortified by my stupidity. Today I f***ed up by putting stupid, inane shit as the memo for my Venmo transactions. Well, actually these transactions are spread out over 2 years. My older brothers and I try to say the most out-of-pocket stuff with our Venmo payments, to try and get a laugh. Everyone does this, right? It's harmless. It's silly. Until you file bankruptcy and have to meet with a trustee in open court who asks about payments made by friends and family. I answer honestly, yes, I've paid friends and family for various reasons. I provided my Venmo transaction history to you. He says, oh, let me check my records. So begins a very, very long pause. I just know he's sifting through the fan favorites, which include, but are not limited to, for the discoloration of your butthole flaps. PP Tom, for the soiled adult diaper auction. Butt plugs and electric shock rods. DVD, black studs, white mums. Your bitch tits. Remember that time you shit in the backyard? For your mother last night, kissing hands and shaking babies. I'm bright red, sinking down in my chair. My lawyer looks at me puzzled. Clearly she didn't read these in depth. Why am I such an immature, stupid f**k? Too long, don't read. I sent my brothers some Venmo with very inappropriate and explicit memos and had to watch in horror as the trustee read them during a court proceeding. Surely in court, it could very easily just be explained away by these were obviously sent to my brothers. You know, they were sent to my brothers and we have an ongoing in-joke where we say stupid stuff to try and get laughs for each other. And that would easily just explain that away. But even if it's explained away, no amount of explaining will ever allow you to just like live down the fact that those Venmo descriptions were just read out in court in front of everybody at the court. Just... And assumedly, I don't really know how it works, but assumedly court records are a thing you can look up, right? Which means that those Venmo descriptions are probably going to be in the court records for that court hearing, should it ever come up in the future, or should anybody ever look them up in the future. That's funny, that's a good one. It's a harmless Tfue, it's a funny little mess up. Sucks to be OP. Tfue by walking in my parents passionately f***ing. Title says it mostly. I accidentally walked in on my dad going down on my mum. This just happened like 15 minutes ago. I was playing Fallout 4 for several hours, and I had no clue where my parents were. Keep in mind that I also have a hearing deficit and was not wearing my hearing aids at the time. On top of that, it's currently very late where I live, so I figured my parents were in bed or something. After playing Fallout 4 for several hours, I go into the hallway and see a small amount of light coming from the game room. I thought that maybe someone had left the TV on, and I went to turn it off. I opened the door, and lo and behold, my father's head is in between my mum's legs, like 6 feet away from me. I just shut the door and ran downstairs and outside. I became a little concerned about what would happen next. My father came outside and I asked, "How are you?" And he said, "Fine, but next time knock." I explained that not only had I been unaware where they were, but it was also late and I thought they were in bed. I also mentioned that I was not wearing my hearing aids and could not hear behind the door very well. I also added on top of that that I saw a light coming from the game room and thought that maybe someone had just left the TV on and I intended to turn it off. I also apologized and said I just made an honest mistake. My father said everything was fine and I had absolutely nothing to worry about. He just said that Fridays and Saturdays are the only 2 days he has time to spend with my mum, so I should be more vigilant about opening a door on those days. Too long, didn't read. I walked in on my parents having sex. My father asked the next time I knock, but he acknowledged that I made a genuine error. I mean, props to him for like being okay with it, you know, and being understanding that it was an accident and like just talking to you about it like an adult, like a human being, and going, honestly, like Fridays and Saturdays are just the when I get to spend the most time with your mom. So like around those days, just maybe knock before you come into rooms, you know? Obviously no one really wants to have that discussion with their parents and no one wants to have this scenario happen with their parents, but like it was handled in a really good way and the dad just talking to them like a human and going, yeah, like let's just make sure this doesn't happen again. Yeah. Like he could have been way less chill about it than he was. So, but anyway, DJ Neko in the comments put it best when they commented, ads for Fallout are getting weird. They are indeed. And the last post. Tfue by making my child vegetarian. I have a 6-year-old son. We went to a fair a few months ago, and there was a display of livestock that the public could pet. Me, trying to be jolly, told him that he'd be eating one of them for dinner someday. My son was shocked and asked how that was possible. I told him that meat is made by killing animals and cooking them. He then asked me what all the meats were. I told him that it's chicken, beef, steak, sausages, salami, and mutton. Later that night at home, I noticed him separating his dinner. He removed all the meat pieces from the rice and only ate the rice. My wife asked him what was wrong, and he said that he doesn't want to eat animals. Thankfully, he's fine with milk and eggs. However, he continued refusing to eat any meat. A week passed and we went to the doctor. The doctor said that it's probably just a temporary phase and we should feed him vegetarian alternatives for the time being. We now buy canned beans, lentils, Greek yogurt, olive oil, whey protein, soy nuggets, and plant-based patties / sausages. We also order a cheese pizza for him. It's been a few months now and I've bought iron B12 gummies for him. Even my wife and I are starting to go more vegetarian. Too long, didn't read. We went to a fair and there was a display where the crowd could pet livestock. I told my son he'd eat those animals soon, and he's a full-blown vegetarian now. I don't actually think this one's a Tfue, OP. I'm sure you're never gonna see this, but like, in my opinion, it's actually a really good sign for the empathy of your child that they heard that meat comes from killing animals and decided that they didn't want to be a part of that. And I think a lot of children tend to do the same thing, whether they stay permanently vegetarian or not. It's quite a common reaction in children to hear that meat comes from actual animals and to go, I'm good, thanks. But ultimately, like, it's not a bad thing for your child to be vegetarian. And it also, as you've mentioned, has allowed you to explore a lot of vegetarian options that I don't think you would have ever seen. And I would like to add, there are actually a lot of vegetarian options now. The amount that you can find and explore are like kind of insane. There's like, at the end of the day, nothing wrong with eating less meat and eating more meat substitutes. I'm not even saying you have to go full vegetarian, but like, vegetarian substitutes aren't just for vegetarians, but there's so many around now, you know? Richmond sausages, I don't know if you can get them in the US, but in the UK, they made the best meat sausages in my opinion. They were always my favorite. I'm vegetarian now. They make the best vegetarian sausages. They're so good. A lot of burgers, you can't even tell the difference. When I was growing up, my dad was vegetarian, so a lot of meals had vegetarian substitutes because, you know, if my mom was making a lasagna, she didn't want to make two lasagnas. So we'd have like vegetarian mince in those. And I honestly couldn't tell you the difference between the two. Like, a lot of vegetarian substitutes are really close to the meat ones now. And if you are reducing your meat intake, you're reducing the effect on the environment that eating meat has. You're reducing the amount of animals that die. Like, there's nothing wrong with more people eating less meat. That's only ever going to be a good thing. Like, I think I looked into it previously. I'll put up actual stats on screen now, but like, I think like 1 in 10 people is like vegetarian or vegan, which means that if every meat eater cut their meat intake by half, it would still have a bigger impact than all of the vegetarians and vegans combined. Like, there's no reason not to, especially when there are meat substitutes that are as good now. Like, if you and I also think that it shows good parenting that you're allowing your son to explore these things. Like, you might feel like you screwed up by like traumatizing your child and making them vegetarian, but you're also allowing that child to explore vegetarian options and to eat foods that he otherwise might not have eaten. And whether he stays vegetarian or not, like, he's been allowed to explore that as an option, which is a good thing. I think that's a good thing. So yeah, just, there's lots of good vegetarian substitutes. There's nothing wrong with eating less meat and replacing some meats with vegetarian substitutes. You don't even have to go fully vegetarian to do that. It's food. It's there for everyone. I will say, however, bacon, there's no replacement. A lot of meats have been replaced and been replaced really well. Bacon just isn't there. Veggie bacon, it's just not. It's just not. It's the one thing I miss. Someone needs to make good veggie bacon. Please, God, someone. I miss it. But that's where I'm going to end the video, everybody. I hope you have enjoyed. If you would like to support me in making more content like this, then I have a Patreon in the description down below, or equally, click on that join button on the channel to support me. It helps a lot more than you might realize, but by no means should you feel like you have to. I'm going to keep making content regardless. A huge, massive special thank you to all of the wonderful YouTube members and patrons that do support me, however. All of your names are up on screen. It genuinely helps so much, and it genuinely means so much. So thank you to everyone that does. Other than that, thank you so much for watching, everybody. I hope you have enjoyed, and as always, I will see you in the next video. Peace out.